Dear students, last class I have taken about the probability and introduction with that conditional probability, also some problems based on it. So today's class also the same thing we are going to take about the conditional probability, some extra problems. The first problem, compute p of a by b. If p of b is equal to 0.5, p of a intersection b is equal to 0.3. Compute p of a by b. If p of b is equal to 0.5 and p of a intersection b is equal to 0.32. So we know the formula. What is p of a by b formula? Solution. We know that. So last class we have taken about that P of A by B formula. P of A by B is equal to P of A intersection B divided by P of B. So what is this one? 0.32 divided by 0.5. So this is 16 by 25, which is equal to 0.64. If you want, you can use the calculator. So this is 16 by 25 is equal to 0.64. You can see here. Next problem. If P of A is equal to 0.8, P of B is equal to 0.5, and P of B by A is equal to 0.4, find P of A intersection B. So this is the another question that I given. What is the question? P of A equal to 0.8, P of B equal to 0.5, and P of B by A equal to 0.4. They are asking you to find out P of A intersection B. How to find out P of A intersection B means you have to make use of the value P of B by A. Solution. P of B by A is equal to P of A intersection B divided by P of A. This is our formula. So P of B by A value they have provided, substitute, that is 0.4 is equal to, don't know the value of P of A intersection B, and 0.8 for this. So we need P of A intersection B. So whatever the denominator is there, you just cross multiply, then it will be 0.4 into 0.8 is equal to P of A intersection B. So 0.4 into 0.8 is nothing but our 0.32. 0.32 is equal to P of A intersection B. So this is our solution. Next one we will take. Next question is important, so I have to star mark it and write the marks allotment. There is 2 marks. So what is the question means? Mother, father and son. Let us take the question. Mother, father and son. Mother, father and son. Line up at random. Line up at random. Line up at random for a family picture. For a family picture. So mother, father and son, what they are doing? They are arranging randomly for a family picture. Some conditions are there, that is events we can form. What is that E event means? Sun on one end. Sun on one end. Next, one more event is that F event. Follow in the middle. Now they are asking you to find out, find P of E by U. So this is our question. Mother, father and son. Let us denote mother with the F, father with the F and son with the S. Yes. First we will try to write down the sample space. Solution. So how I will arrange means how they are going to arrange mothers and father. This is one of the possibility they are going to arrange for a family picture. Mother, son, father. Or else they can arrange like this mother, father and son. They are going to stand up like that also. Or else father, mother, son. This is one of the possibility they are going to arrange for a family picture. Or else father, son, mother. Or else, son, mother, father, son, father, mother. This is one of the possible. So totally six possible outcomes are there. They are going to arrange for a family picture. Other than this, no, it's not there. Only six possible. Now we will write the E event from the sample space. What is E event? Sun on one end. Sun on one end. It means the sun will be at the beginning or sun will be at the corner but not in the middle. So this is not the case because here mother is the first and father is the last. This is possibility because sun is at the last end. So I will write mother, father, son. Similarly this one possible? Yes, it is possible because sun is on the head. F, M, S, I will write. Let's check it out. This is possible? No, it's not possible because sun is middle. We need sun should be corner. This is possible. Yes, yum, yum. And last one is also possible. Yes, yum, yum. So totally four possible outcomes. From the sample space, according to the data, sun should be on one. Next, yum, one. What is our yum? They are asking, father should be in the middle. Is it possible? No. Yes, son is middle. Is it possible? Yes, because father is in the middle. M plus. Now check it out again. No, this is not possible because your mother is in the middle. This is son is in the middle. This is mother and this is possibility because father is in the middle. I'll write S F. Okay. Now they are asking P of E by U. P of E by F means we know the formula P of E intersection F divided by P of F, or else this can generally be found out. So whatever the F has already occurred, this means denominator value is already occurred. So these two values, is it these are present in E? Check it out. Is it present? MF is present. Yes. SFM is present. It's present. How many outcomes are present? Only 2. Divide, you write here 2. That is 2 values are present in E, so I am writing 2. Divided by F value, how many F value? 2. Therefore, there is 2. Which is equal to 1. Probability is 1. Similarly, you can find out with the help of formula. I will take that one. This is our formula, P of E intersection F divided by P of F. So, E intersection F. So, which is the common? This value is itself is a common because it is the smallest value. It means 2. 2 is a common. 2 divided by how much? 2 divided by 6. P of E intersection value is 2 divided by 6. Divided by P of F value, how much P of F value? Again 2 by 6, which is equal to 1. Either you can write directly or else you can go with the formula method also. This is involved. Next one. Take again involvement. Two coins are tossed once. Red on the E event. No head appears. Similarly, take F and no tail appears. Find E by F. So what is our question? Two coins are tossed once. E value, no head appears. F value, no tail appears. Find P of E by F. So two coins are tossed once means you know the possible outcomes from the previous standards. How many possible outcomes? Four possible outcomes. So we will write that one as a sample space. This is HH, HP, or else TH, or else T. So this is our sample space. Now what we are going to write? We are going to write the E event from the sample space itself. What is our E event? No head appears. E is equal to no head appears. It means we have to choose such an outcome where there is an absence of head. In this, head is present, it means we are going to take teeth. Similarly, we are going to write for F. What is F? No tail appears. It means there should be an absence of tail we have to choose. This is tail present. Only remaining is H. Now find the P of E by F. You just go with the formula or else directly also you can. So this is our formula. Better at preferring formula because in your exam point of view formulas are important. So P of E intersection F. First of all, we will take E intersection F. Here E value is TT. F value is HH. Is it any common in that? No, nothing is common. Therefore, probability of E intersection F is 0. Why am I writing 0? Because E intersection F, common factor, nothing is there. Nothing is there means we will write 0. So probability of E intersection F is 0. Now substitute in a formula. 0 divided by P of F is how much is that? 1 outcome divided by 4, 1 by 4. 0 by something value will be 0. So the probability of this question is 0. Probability of E when F is occurred already. What is the value of E? It should be 0. Check it out. This is also important. Next one will go. So next one. next property is also important. Takes time. 10 cars. Number 1 to 10 are placed in a box. Mixed up thoroughly. Mixed up. One card is drawn. Randomly. If it is known that the number on the drawn card. Is more than 3. What is the probability that even number. So this is our question. So first of all, have they looked for the question? 10 cards numbered 1 to 10 are placed in a box. So there are 10 cards. Those 10 cards has been numbered with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And it is placed in a box. And that box is mixed up thoroughly. Whatever the numbers we have put in the box, and that box is mixed thoroughly. And then one card is drawn randomly. Randomly we are going to choose one of the card from that box. If it is known that, if it is known that meant already one of the event has been occurred. What is that? The number on the drawn card is more than 3. This event is already occurred. So now we have to find out what is the probability that it is an even number. What is the probability that it is an even number? Whose probability they are asking? You just take that one as E. Already occurred that one, you take that one as E. So first of all, we will write the sample space for this. What is our sample space type? 1 to 10 we have to write the numbers because cards numbers are 1 to 10. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Now what event we will write? As I said, which is the event already exists, take that one as F. And now whose probability they are asking, take that one as E. Whose probability they are asking? They are asking about the even number probability. This one. Even number. In this, which are the even numbers? 2, 4, 6, 8 and 10. Right? Next, F value. What is F value? It is known that the drawn card is more than 3. What is the number more than 3 from the sample space? These 3 will be deleted. Which will come from 4 to 10, it will be 4. Now they are asking find p of e by n. It is understood. They are not mentioned. What is the probability that it is an even number? Means even number we have taken e and f we have taken more than 3. Therefore it is we have to find out p of e by n. Directly I will write instead of formula. Or else you can use the formula. One problem I am taking based on formula, one problem I am writing directly logically. So why I am doing like this means you can apply your mind so that we can consume our time. In the examination also, if you are writing for this one directly means marks will be provided because it's a 2 marks question. By writing all these data itself, they are going to give the marks. So P of E by N. F value whatever is there, is it E, whatever the F values are there, is it present in E? Check it out. 4 is present, I will round up. 6 is present. Next 8 is present. Next 10 is present. So how many numbers are present in the E? 1, 2, 3, 4. So write that one in numerator. Divided by P of F value. In the F, how many numbers are there counted? It's a 7. So your answer is 4 by 7. If you want, you can tally this with the help of formulas. So this problem is important. Next one is mother, father and son line up at random for a family picture. That is also important. And next I have taken about the two cards are drawn once, no head appears, no tail appears. Those problems are also important. You can go logically. Or else you can go with the help of formula also. Okay. So this is all about the conditional probability. So in the next class we will meet with the multiplication theorem. That is the extension part of the conditional probability. Okay. Thank you.